Hi everyone, and welcome to Quigg Creations November episode of Couch Cabaret. Thank you all so much for watching. And of course, Quigg Creations is a theater slash production company founded to support the LGBTQ plus community. And we produce shows that have more queer stories and queer characters in them, whether it be through original content, producing already known queer friendly content, or upgrading well-known pieces to include more LGBTQ plus characters. In the past month and a half since Quigg Creation has been founded, we have already had two very successful events. The first being the Couch Cabaret premiere event and our live reading of scenes from Hocus Pocus. So I wanna thank everyone who tuned in and watched any of those episodes. I do appreciate it and hope you enjoyed them. But Quigg Creation still has two more events coming up to end 2020. The first one being this month. We are doing a streamed reading of The Burden of Sunflowers, a love story for queer boys in the city, written by Zachary Hub, a play that is near and dear to my heart. We're looking to premiere that episode the last weekend in November. So, make sure you're like us on Facebook and follow us on Instagram so you're aware of when it will premiere. We also have an event coming out in December, a holiday musical review called At Home for the Holidays. And we'll feature classic holiday songs, as well as stories and songs from Polar Express, Elf, How the Grinch Stole Christmas, A Year Without a Santa Claus, and many more. Now, we are still in need of many actors for this event. So if you're interested, please fill out the Google form in the description below. All you need to do is fill it out. And it's going to be a very simple event. All you have to do is I will send you the tracks and recording, the track and lyrics that you will need to be singing. You will film yourself, and you'll send it back to me, and I'll edit it together in this big holiday virtual celebration event. So, again, if you're interested, please fill out the Google form in the description below. I want as many actors as we can to celebrate these holidays, of course, in this unpredictable year. For those of you who don't know, Couch Cabaret is a free event online for all. No ticket necessary, but we have set up a GoFundMe fundraiser that the company does support. And this month, we have picked AIDS United, which was also featured in our Hocus Pocus reading. Now, AIDS United is a nonprofit located in Washington, D.C., fighting to end the AIDS epidemic in the United States. So, if you feel inspired today and enjoy these performances, please feel free to donate anything you can. The links for those fundraiser will be down in the description below. I hope you all enjoyed this month's episode of Couch Cabaret. We have many talented performers featured this month. Now, of course, this episode is premiering on Election Day, so I hope it can provide a little relief for some of you who are feeling a little overwhelmed and stressed out and, an escape during this time. So I really hope we can provide that to you for, just even a little bit of time. We're all in this together, friends, during this difficult time. But sit back, relax on your couch, and enjoy this month's Couch Cabaret.
Bores you? Christ almighty, try working for you for a living. The talking, Jesus Christ, won't he ever shut up? Titanic self-absorption of a man. You stand there trying to look so great when you're nothing but a solipsistic bully with your lectures and arias and let's look at the fucking canvas for another few weeks. Let's not fucking paint, let's just look. And the pretension. Jesus Christ, the pretension. I can't imagine anyone else in the history of art ever trying so hard to be significant. You know, not everything's gotta be so goddamn important all the time. Not everyone wants a piece of art that rips out their guts and exposes their soul. Not everyone wants art that actually hurts. Sometimes people just want a fucking still life, or a landscape, or a soup can, or a comic book, which you might actually know if you ever left your goddamn hermetically sealed submarine here with all the windows closed and no natural light, because natural light isn't good enough for you. But then nothing is ever good enough for you. Not even the people who buy your pictures. So who is worthy of owning your art? Anyone? Or maybe the real question is, who's worthy enough to even see your art? Is it just possible that no one is worthy? That's it, isn't it? We've all been weighed in the balance and have been found wanting. You say you spend your life in search of real human beings, people who can look at your art with compassion, but deep down you no longer believe those people exist. So you lose faith. So you lose hope. So black swallows red. My friend, I don't think you'd recognize a real human being if he was standing right in front of you.